about the structure of the bacteria in detail and also talk about the general characteristics of the bacteria. What is bacteria or what are bacteria? Are they plants? Why they are not plants? Bacteria is the most primitive organism. This is most primitive, one of the most, I should say, primitive organism. We all know bacteria are single celled. These are single celled. They are most primitive organism. They are single celled and are prokaryotes. We'll discuss in the lecture what is the meaning of the prokaryotes. Why we cannot say that the bacteria are plants? Because the mode of nutrition is not autotrophic mode of nutrition. It is not autotrophic. It is then what? It is heterotrophic. What does it mean? Mode of nutrition means the way how they feed themselves. Autotrophic, who are autotrophic? We all know the plants are autotrophs. Why they are known as autotrophs? Auto means self and tropic means nutrition. They themselves make their own nutrition, the nutrients they prepare for themselves. They are known as autotrophs because they make their own food. And so they are known as autotrophs, or we can say that the mode of nutrition is autotrophic. Now, to have mode of nutrition, what? Autotrophic. What is required? To have autotrophic mode of nutrition, one has to have chlorophyll. But here the mode of nutrition is also heterotrophic. So obviously the chlorophyll will also be absent. Chlorophyll is absent. Autotrophic, I hope you all understood. Autotrophic. Auto means self. And tropic means nutrition. So plants are autotrophic. Who are autotrophic? Plants are autotrophics. Why the plants are autotrophics? Because they can prepare their own food. That is the reason the plants are autotrophics. But the one which cannot prepare their own food are known as heterotrophic. Now bacteria also comes under the category of heterotrophic. How they get their food? Again, heterotrophic have many different classes. Maybe parasitic, maybe saprophytic. So the one who do not have chlorophyll, they can't be autotrophic. Their mode of nutrition cannot be autotrophic. They cannot be autotrophs, because to make their own food they have to have chlorophyll. Now the bacteria, even they do not have chlorophyll, that is the reason their mode of nutrition is heterotrophic. Now in heterotrophic also, which mode do they have? So they can be parasitic. Parasitic and saprophytic. Saprophytic and parasitic. Now what is the meaning of parasitic and saprophytic? So I will explain you over here. Now, parasitic mode of nutrition means what? The one which, you know, take the food from the other organism. The one which takes their food from the other organism are known as parasites. The parasites can be ecto and endo. The parasites can be ecto or endo. Ectoparasites, this I'm explaining only parasitism. I'm not talking about the bacteria. I'm explaining only the word parasitic or parasitism. What is the meaning of parasites or parasitism? The one which get their food from the other organism. They don't even make their food, but they do not even take the food from others, but they just also harm the other organism. They also harm the organism. Parasitism is a mode of nutrition in which an organism get the food from the other organism and also what it harms that organism. So it can be ecto. When we talk about ectoparasites, then take the example of the lice, the bed bugs. These are ectoparasites. They suck the blood of the other organisms and take the food. Yes, endoparasites, tapeworms, roundworms, these all are endoparasites. Now we will come to the saprophytes. Saprophytes means what? The one who get their food from the dead and decay organism. The one which get their food from dead and decay organism. I should not say organism. Dead and decay, maybe organism or dead and decay substance. Dead organism and dead and decay parts. So here we are talking about the mode of nutrition of the bacterias. Bacterias are what actually? They are the one of the most primitive organism, one of the most primitive organism. Then they are single celled and prokaryotes. Prokaryotes I'll be discussing in detail because it needs little more detailing. Then I'm talking about the mode of nutrition. The parasites are heterotopic, that means they are not the plants. Plants are autotrophs. Autotrophs, what is the meaning of autotrophs? The one which can prepare their own food. Auto means self, tropic means nutrition. They cannot do it. Why they cannot do it? Because they do not have chlorophyll in them. So then what is the mode of nutrition of bacteria? The mode of nutrition of bacteria is heterotopic. They can be parasitic and they can be saprophytic. Parasites, they live in the body of organism or from the outside the body of organism, other organism. They get their food, they suck their food. Saprophytes, I'm talking in general, saprophytes. So what do saprophytes do? They get their food from dead and decay things. This is about the mode of nutrition. Now, the body of bacteria is not divided into root, stem or leaves. That is the reason this is not the plant. So when we will talk about some other organism, you will find that even those are not plants, but the body is divided little bit like that. So that is the reason here we need to write that body is not, I'm underlining this, not divided, is not divided into roots, stems and leaves.